first of all, the marinade. You have to soak the meats for this pate to give a really good flavour. And I'm going to be using a little bit of venison and some pheasant too. For the marinade, you'll need half a pint of red wine. This can be any old red wine that's been left or the cheapest you can get hold of. So half a pint of wine, a little bit of oil. I'm using about 2 tablespoonfuls. Then some chopped onion, a couple of bay leaves, a few peppercorns, and I've got some garlic down here that I've just split into 4. So that's the soaking liquid, the marinade. Now what I'm going to put in that is the badly shot piece of pheasant here and a little venison, about 8 ounces in total. And I've got that already done. I've had it soaking for 2 days. The principle of a marinade is a soaking liquid and do it for a good long time, 2 days, but cover it tightly with cling film, otherwise it'll smell and you'll get the other things flavoured in the refrigerator. So this has already been soaking and I'm going to add it to the processor. I'm going to make this in a processor, but if you haven't got one, you can easily make it in a blender or you can mince the meats finely. Or coarsely as you like, just however you like the consistency. Now I'm carefully taking out the meat and the onion is going in too, because all that's going to be cooked. The only thing I should be left is a few peppercorns, and also I'll have just a few bay leaf as well. Then in this marinade I'm going to add some bread to soak up the liquid. I'm not bothering to make breadcrumbs. So often you see in a pate that you have to add breadcrumbs. Why not just add the bread, soak it up in the marinade, and it'll be really delicious. Now the other ingredients, I've got the meat in here now, again, in goes the chicken livers. I've got some pork, some minced pork, some chopped pork, and then I've got here's some bacon, and this really is very, very fatty. You couldn't use it for anything else, and it makes it nice and rich. After all, you must have a high proportion of fat in a good pate. Now, this is soaked up very nicely, and I'm going to add that to the, you can see it's got a pinky colour from the wine, to the ingredients, and then I'm going to just strain in the remains of the marinade, keeping back the peppercorns and the bay leaves. Now the other ingredients, we've nearly got everything in. An egg straight in over the top. Fresh herbs. I'm using a lot of herbs in this program. I do like really good fresh herbs. Then pepper. Lots of ground pepper. And then salt. And you'll need 2 teaspoonfuls of salt. Now, if you know that the bacon was very, very salty, you could add less, but I've found in this particular recipe, 2 teaspoonfuls is about right. Now, I look round and see what things I've got left, and I've got 2 cloves of garlic, so let's put those in. Now, you'll notice that I am actually putting it through a garlic press, even though I'm using a processor, because I do find that you need to put it through a garlic press, otherwise you get rather bigger lumps of garlic than you want. So let's collect up some of the debris here and just put it over here. Now, I've got a little bit of nutmeg. In old-fashioned recipes, they always used to use nutmeg, and I think it's a marvellous ingredient. You could use mace if you prefer. Lots of freshly ground. It's a good buy to have nutmegs, you know, because they last, oh, 20 years, a whole nutmeg. So freshly grated in on the top. And then you can keep that hung up on the kitchen, on the wall, on a nail, if you like. Now, that's a nutmeg rolling across the floor. On with the lid, and then twist it on and start it. Let's just have a look and see how it's doing. It's doing very well. It needs just a little tiny bit more. There we are, it's doing really rather well. You can see that lovely fleck of green, but I want it just a little finer than that. That looks just as I like it. So making your own patties, you can make them coarse or fine, just as you like. Take out the blade, first of all, from the processor. And I'm going to put that on the plate and then tip the ingredients into the tin. I've got a two pint container here, and it's all sloppy, and it'll level itself. Now you can see flecks of flat, you can see flecks of meat. I think this is a very good thing rather than a real paste. Now I haven't been giving you the exact quantities, but I'll give that to you a little bit later. So that's filled the 2 pint dish very nicely. I'll put that down in the sink. Great joys of being in my own kitchen, having a lovely big sink to put things in. Level that off. Then put the lid on, and I've set the oven at 350, that's gas number 4, and I've got a dish of water to set it in. If you cook it in with a water surround, I think the French call it bain-marie, you'll find that you get nice even baking, and this will take just about 2 hours. So I'm going to put it in the oven. Now, this is hot, I'm not going to burn myself. I'm pulling the shelf out carefully. Now, set in the oven is a roasting tin, and I've got some hot water in that. And it's a good idea to do that before you start. If it's in the oven, then you don't spill the water on the way. So leave that in the tin of water and let it cook for about 2 hours. And to test when it's done, you put a skewer in, and if the juices that run out of it are clear, you know that it's done. Now I've got one that I've already put in the refrigerator that was baked, cooled, and then it's been allowed to set, and it's in the refrigerator. And I've also put a little bit of aspic on the top, and you just float a little aspic. So you let the pate get quite cold, and the appearance is sort of a bit homely. You can put just chopped parsley if you're in a hurry, but if it's for a party, you can do as I've done, just set a little bit of the aspic with chopped parsley. Let's have a look and see how it looks. I'll lift it out. My family like a good rough pate. I think you'll agree that really is a good homemade pate, and not too expensive either. Let me give you the recipe. For the game pate, you'll need 8 ounces of boned, raw, lean game. This could be venison, pheasant, or whatever you've got. 1/4 pint of marinade, that's the basic one that we made. 1 slice of bread. 8 ounces of belly pork, and that needs to be cubed. An 8 ounce piece of fatty bacon, and that needs to be cubed. 8 ounces of chicken livers. 1 egg. About 2 teaspoons of salt. Lots of ground black pepper. 2 cloves of garlic. And that'll need to be crushed. 1 level teaspoon of ground nutmeg, and 1 tablespoonful of chopped fresh herbs. And then for the topping, if you like, 1/4 pint of aspic. And then the cooking time and temperature, 350 degrees Fahrenheit, that's 180 degrees centigrade. Gas number 4 for about 2 hours. And to test when it's done, just pierce it with a skewer, and if the juices come out clean, then it's ready. And it'll serve 12 as a first course or 8 as a main course.